Death by Doom.
Hello, everybody. It's Christopher James here. Can someone in the chat, please? This is my first time doing streaming, so I'd appreciate if someone could just give me the thumbs up that you can hear me okay, that you can all hear my mic in that. That'd be terrific. Just looking into the chat here to see if we've got, you can hear my sound okay. Beautiful. Thank you, Luis84. I hope you and your daughter are doing wonderful. I got a small screen here, so I'm trying to do a million things at once. Anyways, welcome everybody. My name is Christopher James. This is a Warrior Talks. I'm going to be doing these communications to the world every Thursday night. And we need to drill down on the very simplicity of what's before us here today in this world that requires all of us to come together. And God bless the fact that we have this internet right now to be able to communicate to people worldwide in a very simple and a very straightforward way. It's been a long day for me here today. I've had to learn, just, you know, in the background, I've had to learn this operating software, this OBS it's called, that's doing the streaming here for me this evening, that helps me put the videos together, the transitions. And so it's been a little bit of a learning curve, but I'm always up for the challenge for that. So that's more or less the stressful part of everything. I think saving the world is a lot easier. But this is the first of a Warrior Talks, which are going to be many, that I'm going to be carrying every Thursday night. This initial talk, we're going to drill down really on the simplicity of what's going on in our world right now. And I'm also going to further share and teach people through the knowledge that I've acquired over the many years, the simplicity, which applies to every single man and woman that's in this country today. Okay. I'd first like to say, it's just, you know, that opening section there, my background for people that don't know, I have a website called awarriorcalls.com. Please go there and subscribe. It's very important at this time, because what the subscription does is it puts you into a database for us that I'm also tied to with Earth United Global, which Jesse Casanova has incredibly put together, and it's still a work in process, but these are the early stages now when we start to pull the world together, as we call it. I'm gathering the clans. And we are going to have a very open and very direct conversation on what is going on, and also the simple solution in moving forward, because it is truly simple. Because our world today is being driven by fear, as all of us know, from these enormous lies that are being spread for those of us that are awake, that's going on in our world right now. And the quickest way to take down a lie, to take fear away, is with knowledge. And I'm going to do my best with all my heart to educate everybody quickly, powerfully, and simply, so that you can share this information with your fellow man worldwide, because the exact same documentation that we're going to talk about this evening, the exact same trespass, that's a key word that we're all going to learn about. There's three very important words, I'll state them right now, that you need to master. One is property, the second word is trespass, and the third word is who. On my website, I have a very detailed explanation of what falls under property, your rights. It's not just, you know, your physical things like cars, boats, lands, homes. It's anything that's exclusive to you. And it's very important when you understand and you only use that word property. Because in this world, I'm going to give you the keys to the kingdom right now, is that no man or woman can administrate property without right. That's very powerful. Because when you stand before any man or woman in this world, for example, Justin Trudeau, the man who's acting as prime minister of this country, he works for a service corporation, okay? It's called Canada. And we, the people, are the employer, okay? They are the employees. This is the simplicity of what you need to understand. It's a service corporation, no different than McDonald's, Burger King, Tim Hortons, except those other ones, they provide us a far much better, more service, and tasty, I might say, at some times. But Justin Trudeau is just a man. And that man, if you stood in front of him, or you bring him into, more importantly, a public courthouse, and you place him on the stand under oath or affirmation, and you simply ask him one question. Justin, am I, and when I use the word I, that means every man and woman in this country, even though I don't speak for every man and woman in this country, truth does. Remember that. And when truth is present, very few words are required. Okay, I'm giving everything to you very, very quickly here so you understand, and very simply. I don't think I've lost anybody so far on what I've been talking about. So when you simply have a man like Justin Trudeau in front of you, or any man or woman in this world, the first thing you ask them, am I property? Do you claim I property? And they're going to say, well, of course not. Of course you're not my property, because slavery was abolished a very long time ago. And you say, well, that's good. And can you, Justin, or any man or woman under your control, administrate property without right? And he's going to say, no. That's like me showing up at your house. I take your car. I take your bike. I take your wife, you know, and do what I wish, so to speak. Right? That is a trespass. And that's me administrating somebody else's property. You might say, wait a minute, Christopher, you said a man's wife. Well, in common law under God, when you have someone that you were in love with and you enter in an exclusive relationship, in the old days, today the relationships are, you know, far more, you know, outside of the box, so to speak. But in this particular case, if you understand the common law and you understand your creator, that when you do find someone in this world and you do commit to them, that you are exclusive to them and they are exclusive to you, and you are their property. Okay, and they are your property in the very essence of it. And when you have children, when you bring these incredible beings into this world, they are property. They are your property until they are of age of consciousness where they can protect themselves through hopefully the learnings and the trainings and the teachings that their mother and father has provided them through the wisdom and knowledge that hopefully they've acquired in their life as they've moved along. The problem is in this world is that there's been an enormous amount of knowledge hidden from us. There's been an enormous amount of lack of education right from the time that you're in kindergarten right up to you come out of university. It's all been convoluted. It's all been, it's been created in such a way that it's kept enormous truths from our world. And these truths are incredibly powerful. And one of these truths, as my website speaks to, one truth will save this world. It's not a slogan. It's the truth. And you're going to learn of just one of these truths here this evening. And it affects all of us in this world because all of us have the evidence of it surrounding it. So let me first start by saying that all these streams as well that we're doing here tonight are going to be re-uploaded onto my website and to Earth United for the world to see. Please download them. Please share them. Please spread these as far and wide as you can. It is very important right now that we start to begin the process of something that's never happened before in this country, where the world, not only in this country, but in this world, where we're actually going to have a conversation for the first time with the world. Outside of mainstream media, completely open, completely transparency. And this conversation that we're going to have here is a conversation that should have happened a long time ago with all of us, with our parents, with our grandparents, but they were never taught these truths. They were never shown these truths. They were kept hidden from them. And they, throughout their life, have been enslaved, no different than we've all been enslaved, only and simply by one aspect, and that is ignorance. Okay? It's not that we are stupid people. It's not that we're lazy. All of us, we're incredible beings, we're incredibly intelligent, we're incredibly bright, but we have had enormous foundational truths, many of them that have been kept from us on who we are, in which this world we live, and how everything is actually working in this world. So I go back to the keys of the kingdom, which I was originally speaking to you about earlier, and that is property. That's a very powerful word. You do not need to go past those two questions to any man or woman. Any man or woman that's putting a piece of paper in front of you, any man or woman that has some order or something that's in front of them, unless you're in a restaurant, okay? They have no jurisdiction control over any man or woman. And remember that, okay? You're not their property. And unless they have a contract with you where you've relinquished your rights, okay, then nothing that they say or nothing that they put in paper in front of you applies to you. They can write your name in all capital letters. They can write it in upper lower. They can write it in Jell-O. They can write it in Fujiland. It doesn't matter. At the end of the day, that's just a piece of paper. Okay? That's a different dimensional world. And that's how the court systems work today. They work in a two-dimensional world on what's on paper. Yes, you see a man wearing a robe standing there or sitting there acting as a judge or a justice. You see all these other actors in the court. So let me give you another foundational, powerful truth as well. The second that you are born in this world, okay, every man and woman is born equal under the law. And the law is the law of that land, okay, which comes from our creator. Okay, we are all born equal. And that's what's supposed to occur when we walk into our public courthouses, when we're standing there and there's another man and woman on the other side of that courtroom that's moving some claim or court against us. The problem is that is not as what is occurring. And that's why we have to go back to the very first moment, the very most, again, one of the most important words is trespass. And this is what occurs when we are all born, okay? The moment that we are born in hospital, this entity that exists in this world that was here long before we were here is incredibly evil, that has control of everything right now, from our banking, from our medicine, from our mainstream media, from our television communications to our newspapers. They control it all. And this isn't conspiracy theories. My background was in the music and entertainment industry. For many years, my life was basically eat, sleeping, and breathing in the music and entertainment industry. I was very passionate about that. And my background, like I said, as a writer, producer, and engineer, it's what drove me 24/7. And I began creating a project that was supposed to launch globally in 2001. And in 2003, that's when the curtain, you could say, got pulled back for me. And I was shown this enormous truth that I did not know existed surrounding the creation of money. And this all went to the Federal Reserve. And there's lots of information that is out there for everyone to understand. But ultimately, what we're talking about tonight is that there are three entities, okay, that are behind all of this corruption in this world right now that we see. First is the central bankers, okay, along with the Queen and along with the Pope, okay? These are the three heads of the snake, so to speak. Once you do the research, and some of the documentation that I'm going to show you here this evening is going to support and show all of you the truth at which I and millions of other people now are starting to realize around this world. Let me just grab a quick drink here. So what happens is that for those of you that are unfamiliar with this and that this is your first time hearing about this information or whether it's your thousandth time hearing it, my research and my work has provided me of 20 years of battling in the courts, of helping people, keeping my head down. I had an initiative, like I said, that was to launch in 10 countries back in 2003. What I created would blow the doors off Google and YouTube today. Okay, and I did this before there was a Facebook, before there was a YouTube. I was ahead of my time. This is not an I Love Me show. These are facts because it's important. The foundation of truth always requires you understand where that truth is coming from. And I am an open book on my background and what I've done to get to this point. And if you go to my website, there's a small little brief description of what I and my family have gone through to get to this point. And it is only through the grace of God that I remain before you here today. Because for the last 20 years, I have been completely, my life's work got, you have no idea what it's like to work towards something and know you've got something incredible where Microsoft and Cisco partnered with you immediately. I had the gentleman named Alan Lee, who you may not know from Lord of the Rings, the trilogy, the motion pictures work. He flew over specifically to see me in 2003, and he offered his services to me for this initiative that I created. Again, it was a global light that I was bringing to the world, but I was using the music and entertainment industry. So what happened was that Alan ended up offering his services to me for free. And then it was shortly after that that I realized that my life's work and everything that I'd been working up till that point was never going to come to fruition. And it was devastating. I was numb for probably a year. It was a punch to the gut. You just couldn't breathe. You cannot imagine what it was like to realize everything I've worked for was not going to come to fruition because of this evil that I was starting to see now that exists in this world. And that was the central bankers where it started. And then from there, I spent the next 15 years doing enormous research. I've got about 55,000 files that are in my vault, I guess you could so to speak say, files which I've kept of truth and knowledge that I've vetted. And what happens is that once you start, I've looked at everything across the full spectrum, from everything from technology right through financing to things that are on world and off world. Okay, the whole gauntlet I've dug down on for the last 20 years to understand what the hell is going on in this world. Okay, because my life's work, I knew I was going to bring this light forward, and all of a sudden it was ripped away from me, and I wanted to know why. I've always been a dog with a bone, so to speak, is that when I get my head wrapped around something, I'm relentless with it. I will go at it no matter what. No matter if I keep getting knocked down, I will keep getting back up, and I will fight and fight and fight to get to that truth. I will do whatever it takes. What I didn't mention is that when this happened with my initiative launching globally, it destroyed my family as well financially, who put everything on their basket. We all had perfect credit scores. We owned house or whatever, and I destroyed all of them. And I've been carrying that now for the last 20 years. So what started out for me to get to the bottom, to understand, to hold people accountable for all this wrong and harm that was occurring. And there were many other things that transpired after my initiative shut down. I got into commercial lending. And that's when I bared witness to enormous financial fraud, especially against the elderly people in this world, what's going on. I worked with all levels of law enforcement. So people know me within the law enforcement. They're scratching their heads now because 10 years ago, I flipped in their world. They started looking at me like, oh, he's gone off the deep end now. He's acting like these freemen or these sovereign citizens, as they like to label us. When in actual fact, I was becoming more and more awake to the situation, but I did not have the simple solution. I knew the basics of what was going on that we're going to talk about here tonight, but it was only till about a year and a half ago when that weight was finally lifted off my shoulders. And now there's no man or woman in this world that I can't take down quickly in a court. Okay, there's no man or woman in this world that's going to own me or control me. Okay, and that's the power of knowledge. All right, it's not coming from a place of, you know, ego or you're trying to be difficult or combative. There's none of that with me. The trespass that occurred against us all when we were first born is one of the most horrific acts that could ever happen to any of us, because it has corrupted everyone's consciousness. My fellow man doesn't know who they are. They think they do, but they don't. And as I say to people, I didn't become a man. I didn't start to learn how to become a man until about 10 years ago, when I started to really understand what happened when I was born in a hospital, and documentation that my mother and father were signing that they were not given full disclosure of. And that is still carrying on in this day. And why this is so important, the simple truth, why my website speaks to and why I always speak to, one truth will save our world. Why? Because it's the truth. This one truth that you're going to share and we're going to discuss here this evening happens to every single man and woman when they're born in this world. Maybe not in the, you know, the deep parts of Africa or the rainforest where the tribes and that are. Of course, they don't do this, but pretty much everywhere else in this world, in some form or capacity, this trespass that happens against us when we're born is occurring. And you say, well, Chris, well, what is this trespass? Well, this trespass is very simple. When we're born, and I can show you the initial document here, we have a record that's called, in Canada here, it's called the Statement of Birth. Okay, Statement of Live Birth. You know, and it's really funny. I've looked at this thing for many years, and this is the, I'm sorry I can't get this smaller. If I got it smaller in the whole screen, you wouldn't be able to read any of it. So I've blown it up so that I can, as I can scroll down, I can show you different things. But as you look at the top of this document, it says the Vital Statistics Act Statement of Birth, okay? All this document is, to keep things simple, this is the beauty of this when you understand the simplicity of this is a record, okay? You were only moments old when you were born, and documentation such as this is being created. Now, when this documentation was being created, were you given full consent of it? No. Were you given any full disclosure and knowledge of what's occurring with this documentation that's being created, also which your parents are signing? No. So all you have to understand is that document is simply a record. No words on that other than the name that was given to you from your mother and father apply to you. And the doctor's signature again. When you scroll down further into the document, you will see that it says at the very bottom, in Canada here, it has Registered General, okay? It's a certified copy. This is where your document ultimately goes, okay? When they're creating these documents at first in hospital. Inside this document, you're going to see, you see this little thing here. Well, this is the actual form that was filled out when my mother and father were in the hospital shortly after I was born. And this document is set inside a template. If you look on the, again, I apologize for this, but when you look on the outside, this is kind of a lot, much larger document that's here. And you can tell it's in a much larger document when you go to the top of it, because at the top of it here, you can see that we have all this stuff. See all this border that's going around? Okay, so this is what was set up in all these countries. Who set this up? Well, again, this was the Pope, where all this began with a long time ago, thousands of years ago. They didn't have this particular system in place, but it's a system that's been ever changing and ever encroaching on mankind. Their objective has been to strip mankind every man and woman, from knowing who they are and from their relationship with their Creator. And the most important thing, the love and the power that we truly all have in this world as a man or woman. And they do this immediately when you're born on paper, because they kill you literally on paper. This documentation that I'm showing you here, again, is just a record. Do not pay attention to what is stated on it, okay? Everyone has some form of a hospital record, or there's an initial record. This is known as the founding document, okay? And I just want to point out something just the other night that I noticed this, which is really incredible, because all throughout life, this system that's been around us has forever been chipping away, unbeknownst to us, to our consciousness. And they do it through the television, they do it through radio, they do it through print, they do it through education. So they change things along the way. This is the power that the system has over us that's been out there for a very long time. Everybody is indoctrinated into a collective consciousness of how things work. And it's been reinforced through the mainstream media. When you watch a police show or a detective show, you always see that there's a man acting as a prosecutor. You see a judge, a man wearing a robe, and he has ultimate control. And everyone's supposed to abide by the orders that he beaks out and the processes and everything that he's running within that court. This stuff is in, again, you're continually unknowingly being conditioned as you're watching these various movies and television shows, because they're trying to repeat how they want you to see the world. Okay, that's why it's called television, right? They're telling you the vision that you want. That's why it's called television programming, because you're being programmed. Okay, it's very sick what's actually going on. But the very first trespass, and that's a word you must understand, that's all you ever use. If someone steals from you, if someone breaches a contract, if someone damages you, if someone, you know, cheats on you with your wife, whatever it is that occurs, it's a trespass. That's how simple you need to use that word, and it's powerful. And then after the word trespass, you identify what the trespass is, theft, fraud, etc. Okay? And that's what makes these common law filings, once we get further into these series, when you see how to file a claim in a public courthouse, how simple it actually is. Okay? Because you're moving your court in a public courthouse, and your claim is always usually the same 8 words. You know, it's a handful of words at the top, and then you address who the parties are, and then away you go. But before we get to that part, let's go back to this first trespass, and the only trespass that we're bringing forward right now that is most paramount for this world and moving forward. And that's when we're first born. So in this moment, this paperwork is being filled out and your mother and father are not being told what is occurring. You can see here, my name is printed in all capital letters. This is what the staff is trained to do at all hospitals. The doctors are ignorant of this stuff. The nurses, God bless them, all these people that are trying to provide good faith and duty services to us, they have also been lied to. That's the foundational truth that's here for everybody in this world, is that we have all been lied to from the very first breath that we have taken. Our mother and father, our grandparents, everyone. And it's time that we take care of this once and for all. We bring this truth out into the light. For the moment that this truth comes out into the light, all of this corruption in this world is going to be wiped out, because the people are going to access their public courthouses en masse correctly, and we are going to correct and hold all of these people that are committing enormous wrong and harm, and in many cases, genocide. When you understand that this entire system that's put in place at every hospital around the world, in every country, it's a form of enslavement, okay? And they're doing this because there is only ignorance surrounding it, and they've gotten away with it for so long, but the gig is up for them. So as we get into this, I wanted to point something out. I've looked at this document many times, and I just happened, as I was putting this together today for the slide or whatever, I honed in on one particular area. If you look on where it says line 5, it says, please state, I don't know if how that's coming out in the actual screen there, but what it says, if you can see, putting my cursor on the studio software, and I'm thinking you guys are going to see it. If you look at line 5, it says, please state if mother is married, widowed, divorced, or single. Well, she's married, but pay attention what they've put underneath that. The term common law or separated, not to be used. Okay, so there's reasons for why they do these. Now, you may not have that particular language in there. Some birth certificate, some of these documents, when they are created, they list the mother and father as informants. Okay, so what happened is after this is just a record. Okay, this is the record that your mother and father filled out in the hospital. And then shortly after that, your mother and father, they get this document. Might look similar to yours, it's different in every country, but they get what is known as a birth certificate. Okay, you'll see my name there. It's on this birth certificate. The most important thing you need to understand, did you create it? No. Has nothing to do with you. The service corporation, these people, through documentation they're creating in the back end, they created this document. It's actually a bond, okay? But it has nothing to do with you. It's actually evidence of identity theft, okay? As you will see when you blow it up in Canada here, if you look at the very bottom, I don't know how big you can blow it up, but it says Canadian banknote right at the bottom under the word certificate. Okay, what is that doing on a document if that applies to I as a man or to you as a woman? Okay, it doesn't. The only thing you need to recognize is that you will notice that the date of birth is shown when you were born in the hospital, but there's also a second date. And that one here shows December 23rd, 1966. And that is the date that this was registered. Okay? Now, what was registered? Okay? You didn't consent to anything being registered. Registered is a very powerful word. This is something you also need to know. Something is, you never, a man or a woman, never, ever, 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 ever registers anything. And yet, that's what we've been doing with our cars, our boats, our homes, and everything. Why do we never register anything? When you register something, you are turning over control, jurisdiction, to whoever you are entering into some sort of agreement with. okay? And people do not understand this. And the trick that they've played on this is that when you are born, they take an extract from that first document that we looked at, that statement of birth, and then they go and create a second document, and that is this birth certificate. And from this birth certificate, that's what these service corporations called governments all around the world then go and create driver's license, all these other things, health card, etc. And you'll see your name in all capital letters, and you'll see that it's in different combinations on each one. Again, what you are seeing here is multiple corporations being created in your name without your consent, okay? And we are all ignorant to all of this. We all see our picture on a piece of this plastic and we think, oh yeah, that's me, that applies to me. But you don't stop to think, well, what do all these numbers mean around this? What does a certificate actually mean? It's a financial instrument, okay? So this service corporation, when you were born, and in my case, it's the Ontario government in Canada, trespassed against me, and unbeknownst to my mother and my father, the documentation that they were simply signing, believing that they were placing a record of their son being born into this world, they are actually setting up a back-end system of massive theft, fraud. Okay, because through this documentation, it created an unlawful conversion, because anytime a man or a woman, okay, changes their capacity, okay, from when you act as a police officer or a fireman, as a baker, whatever, whenever you're acting in a role in this world, you have diminished your capacity and your power that you hold as a man or a woman when we came into this world. Remember, we're all equal as a man or woman. But the second you go off and act at something, you have diminished your capacity, because in every single role that you're going to act in, doesn't matter if it's police, fireman, doctor, nurse, whatever, factory worker, what do you have? You have duties and obligations. Remember that. And those duties and obligations do not trump the rights of a man or a woman. See how simple that is? It's very simple to understand. So when you start to, you know, correct your consciousness, and that's what this is ultimately about here. Your consciousness has been corrupted from a very long time ago, and I'm here to correct it. And I'm here to do it very simply, very powerfully, with love, and to bring you forward into the world how you should actually be presenting yourself to this world. All of us should be acting with each other in this world when we're engaging and moving forward, because our world right now is being driven by these very people that set up these systems in all these countries a long time ago. They are doing things right now in this world, as we know, this colossal fear that's being placed upon everybody. All of it is based on a lie. And the only way, when you say, you know, when people say, well, geez, Chris, I'm only one man or one woman, what can I do against a pope or a woman who acts as a queen or a bunch of central bankers that are on the other side of the world and they're all powerful? And I say this to you, that public courthouse that is local to you, that is the most powerful place that we the people can go and access and correct any wrong and harm. The problem is, we've not been accessing our courthouses properly. Why? Because we've been trusting in a society that we do not belong to called the bar, lawyers. They deal in legal world, okay? And that has nothing to do, just so you know, the legal world is the world of the dead. And you say, world of the dead? Yes, remember I told you earlier, it only deals in paper. What's on paper? Well, what was created when you were born? That's a fiction, okay? That's a fiction that these service corporations created, and then they sent it to you saying that this is documentation for you and this is who you're supposed to believe who you are. But the fact of the matter is that they created a fiction on paper, and it's not you. So when you walk into these public courthouses, it's that fiction, okay? It is that legal person which they created and sent to you at birth that's being brought into that court. See, he who creates owns. So when you understand the separation of this unlawful trespass first at birth, we have to go right back to this foundational trespass and correct it, okay? And the first way we correct it is consciously, okay? There's a process that we can work through in creating documentation, your correct ID, and then again, we don't register something. What do we do with it? We record it on the land, on the record. So you would go to the land registry office, for example, which is not functioning correctly in any of our countries properly now, except for the United States. They've actually started to create and open up their proper land registry offices so that people can go there when they have their correct ID properly created now. Remember, you're your own, you know, you're in charge of your own life in this world. You have to take responsibility here. So you create your own identification. You can use the documentation as the first statement of birth that I showed you there. Why would you use that as part of your ID? Because it's a record, okay? It was a record and many people witnessed it. Their names are on it, their stamps are on it from the service corporation through people, staff that worked at the hospital and your mother and father. So you use that as the record. And then you create the actual document that represents the man or the woman as shown again on my website. I've got a template there of three of them there. The reason that these are all large pages is because I've used them for when I've gone into a court so that the court is crystal clear on who, there's that word again, who is appearing before them, okay? So This birth certificate, again, is a trespass. Now, we talk. I talk in my videos about the CUSIP number that's on the back. When I originally received my birth certificate, this one here was laminated. When I flip it over on the back, there's nothing on it. There was no numbers or anything. This is part of the research that many people around the world have uncovered and found out. You know, this massive, it's basically a baby slave trade that goes on in the background. And if you go to www.annavonrights, that's R-I-R-E-T-Z.com, R-E-I-T-Z.com, annavonrights.com, put in her search window there, baby slave. Okay, and you will come up and pull up a PDF that is an incredible, historical, and well-written and vetted document that is backed by all the evidence that they have. And it shows you how this process began a long time ago until they brought in these birth certificates. And it's an incredible read. Okay, this is part of the knowledge. This is something that everybody needs to understand what has gone on that leads up to the moment that we were born in this hospital. So this system that we're talking about now got rolled out in 1934. And again, this is the birth certificate that is sent to me. Again, this has nothing to do with me. Nothing to do with me. It's evidence, again, of a trespass against me. They've taken an extract from that statement of live birth from the nurse writing the all capital letters, and then they've gone and created a corporation, a legal person, a legal fiction, a dead entity that only exists on paper. And that's what they claim that they own, and that entity which they created is bound to taxation. It's bound to codes, rules, and statutes. It's bound to the legal world. See how simple that works? Legal does not apply to a man or a woman. Remember that. Only lawful does. And you say, well, where does that come from, Christopher? Well, the word law is a very powerful word, which is also on my website. L stands for land. That's the jurisdiction of the land. That's common law. That's the law that came to us from our Creator. It's the law that is unwritten because it's within all our hearts. We know the difference between right and wrong. We know we don't administrate or trespass against another man or woman's property. See how simple that is to understand? It's very powerful once you understand the use of these words and then you implement them into our world today. So what has happened is that when this trespass occurs to us at birth, our parents and everyone go home and everyone thinks everything's hunky-dory, but then in the background, there is this financial chicanery going on, I guess you could say. And I can show you this again. My current birth certificate that's on the screen here did not have what's known as a red CUSIP number on the back of it. Okay, so I mailed away, and you can see that it was done on January 31st, 2014. That's when I reapplied for this document to resend to me. And as you can see, this is how it came in the long form here. There's my Christopher James again. There's all these other different dates again. It's a birth certificate. I have no idea what this is about. But then I went and I looked, flipped it over and I looked on the back. And then on the back, here's where you see, that's where the red CUSIP number is. Okay? So at the end of the day, this is really, it's evidence, okay, that everybody needs to drill down on. Now, whether you see it in your various countries or not is irrelevant, okay, because the fact of the matter is that this documentation that was created when you were born, you did not consent to it, and is being used to control you in this world, has been used to fleece you, to steal. That's why no one owns property, technically, in this world. You don't own anything. You think that you bought a house and you own your house? You think you bought a car or a boat and you own your car and your boat? No, you don't. And you're saying, well, what do you mean, Chris? I got the contract right here. I got the titles right here. Look at the title. Look what got put on title. That creation when you were born. That fiction. That all-cap name. It's simply a corporation. And you've been misled because you see your name and you believe that applies to you. Whenever a man or woman's name, like we were all taught, like this is how simple this is. We were never taught to write our name in all capital letters. Right? Always the first letter was whatever your initial was, and then the rest was lowercase. That's how a man and a woman communicate to each other. But what's hid from us is that over time is that people a long time ago, when they used to see the name in all capital letters, they'd recognize right away that that was not a man or a woman. Okay? So these are the very foundational things that have been removed and kept from us. But as we move forward here in this process here, I just want everyone to understand something, that there's an enormous amount of fear that we're being driven from in this world. And we're going to get through all of this very simply and very quickly. Because I already handed the keys to you to the kingdom at the top of this discussion once it opened up. When I said to all of you that any man or woman that is putting a piece of paper in front of you, or any man, that especially in a court, or any man or woman is claiming that they have a right to order you around, to stay in your home, to be locked down, to be forced to wear a mask, who is that man or woman that's going to come forward that claims that you're property that's making these statements? Nobody. Is Doug Ford going to claim that I'm property, the man that's acting for the Service Corporation Ontario government in Canada? No. You get him into court, though, and Justin Trudeau, and you simply put them under oath, under a common law court proceeding, and you simply put those two questions to you, to them. Am I, and which will always stand for we the people in this country, am I, or any man or woman, property of the man named Doug Ford or Justin Trudeau? And they're going to stand under oath or affirmation. Absolutely not. That's right. And does Doug Ford or Justin Trudeau, can they administrate property without right? So I know I've said that already, but you need to understand the power of that words, of those words. Who can administrate property without right? You can't. And if you do, you're liable for it. And this is what you need to understand, the power that's coming forth in this world, this truth. Because this trespass that's occurred against us at birth is the foundation for everything. It's how the banking system's been set up. Go and look at your bank account, right? It's not even your bank account. That's how a service corporation called Ontario or Canada can come into a bank, a corporate bank account, and they can take your funds. Why? Because the name on the bank account is not you. You see your name, but it's that corporation. It's that fiction. It's that legal entity which they created when you were born. That's what's on title at the bank account. Now that should really rub you the wrong way. Okay? And this is why the people in the world have to wake up to this simple, unlawful conversion that happened against us at birth. Because what does all this documentation that they created truly drill down to and actually mean? It's called constructive fraud. So it's real simple. There was a trespass when you were born. And what happened to that trespass? Well, there was an unlawful conversion. They converted you from a man or a woman, and then they went and created, in their world, a legal person, a corporate entity. And see how simple that is? Because they've created an all caps name and they claim that that's their property, which it is. They created it. Only one problem. They didn't ask, or they fully didn't disclose to we the people when we were born what they were doing. So when fraud is apparent in anything in this world, it eviscerates all once you start moving these actions that into a courtroom. So this is what our world, which we're working on right now to simply explain to everybody. And that's what this initial talk with everyone here in this chat here tonight is about. I want everybody to know from around the world that this has occurred against all of us. It's still occurring today in our hospital. And there's a very simple way for us to correct all of this. And the beauty of this is this foundational trespass is actually at the heart of our action that we're going to do in the next few months, in the middle of October to November. And we'll bring people along up to speed with it as we get closer to that. But at this point, the most important point for everybody is to simply get their consciousness corrected, to simply understand what has occurred when you were born. And once we move from that position moving forward, everyone is going to simply see how we stop all of these actions that are occurring against us. You know, when you know how to act like a man, yes, they're going to be, because the system right now has these people that are acting in police who, again, I repeat, who are ignorant. They've also been lied to. And I believe in those people. I'm here because I believe in my fellow man and woman. I'm here because I believe in this great country, Canada, and this world. And I'm here because I believe in myself. Okay? I haven't fought through, you have no idea what has gone on in my life for the last 20 years to get to this point. I should actually be thanking everybody that's here tonight for providing counseling for me, because it's been a hell of a journey for me to get to this point. But I'm not going to fail. I can see that we're not going to fail now. And I've been incredibly blessed that as this journey began for me to bring this website forward, which was only supposed to deal with the common law, when this other entity, which we know is driving the world right now with fear, appeared back in December, I was very much aware what was actually going on. Okay, and again, this goes back up to the central bankers. It goes back to the three heads of the snake that are controlling and running everything. Our world, the people, are being attacked right now, all of us. Okay, and this is only occurring because of we lack knowledge. And when you understand the simplicity of this power, it's truly incredible. For example, the other day I go to the beer store, right? And they've got all the big signs up. Put a mask on. You're not allowed in, blah, blah, blah. I walk right in the store. Okay? No mask on, no nothing. Guy looks at me behind the counter, one at the restaurant. He points me, says, sir, you have to have a mask. I says, it compromises my immune system. Right away, he's like, oh, sorry, sir. And then when I went up to actually get my beer, the man that was doing it at the cash register, man, it breaks my heart. There's a guy, there's a shield that's up in front of us, this massive wall of glass, little tiny window to stick the thing for your, if you're going to do a bank payment through your card or whatever they've got there. But the guy on the other side of the glass, he's also got a visor on. He's got a mask. and he's got gloves. Okay? All of this is going to stop, and it's going to stop very soon. We have some incredible stuff that's coming forward. There's interviews that I've been working on here for the last few weeks, several interviews, and we're going to start to bring forward people that are of incredible capacity and of knowledge that are going to stand with this world in the coming months, and they're going to bring forth in their respective countries this truth. And we're going to move these truths, these claims, into our public courthouses. And it's going to be done en masse. It's going to be done honorably. It's going to be done courageously. But more importantly, it's going to be done powerfully. This is the conversation that's never happened in our world, and we're having it now. It begins here. It began a few months ago with an incredible man who I came across. His name was Jesse Casanova. For those of you that don't know, we also have a website called earthunited.global. Please go to it. That is the point of the spear, you could say, for this light which we are bringing forward. And that light is not me. That light is the truth at which I'm laying in front of everybody. Everybody has to stop, put everything aside, quiet your mind, and understand this trespass that occurred against you. Because once you understand this trespass, we move from a knowing to a place of doing. And that's when we start to go to these public courthouses en masse, and we are going to correct this record quickly that it happens against all of us. And in that moment, this legal system that has been causing enormous and horrific harm is going to be wiped out. It's no longer going to attack or hurt another man or woman ever again. There's an enormous amount of forgiveness that's going to have to occur with these people and members that are of the bar, but there's many of them that are probably looking at a rope around their neck for what they've done to us, okay? That's how serious this is, because this isn't some kumbaya moment where I've got nothing better to do to be on this broadcast here this evening. There's nothing more serious upon this truth that I'm bringing forward to you and what is coming down on us right now in this world, as you know, is this financial tsunami, plus all these other mandatory things they're trying to implement onto everybody right now that is all based on a lie. And I can say that because I have the evidence for it. And I have the actual woman that I'm going to bring to you in the very near future that's going to basically blow your minds. And this is what we're going to be pushing out here. It's a very powerful time in our world for truth. And we must do all we can right now to come together and bring this truth forward and out and into the light. So this, you know, like I said, this first broadcast for me was very important to begin to introduce myself to the world. I'm very grateful for all my YouTube subscribers. I'm very grateful for people from around the world now that are coming from these various different organizations that are all merging. And that's something I do want to tell you is occurring right now. We have over 200 organizations right now in the back end that are all coming together. And we have all these people that have been on the front line. This is why you have to spread this word. Send them to a Warrior Calls, have them sign up. Pardon me, subscribe so that they can be put into our database so that we have a way of connecting with them. Also, go to earthunited.global and subscribe there as well so that you receive these communications, because the back-end system that we're putting in place will ensure that we will be able to contact you to let you know to keep this truth flowing, because this internet is a very precious thing. And it is my personal opinion, based on enormous research and many other people understand right now, is that they will pull the plug on the internet in the near future, or they will shut my YouTube channel down, right? Which is a real shame, because YouTube was an incredible, you know, platform that they launched and allowing people to communicate in a way that was never possible before. Allowing people to share truth outside of a filtered, you know, mechanism that has kept all of us in ignorance for so long. But what happened was is that as the system was being brought into play, I guess you could say, in the 1995, as they were bringing it all up and all this connectivity was happening, it's a double-edged sword for the powers that be that want to implement all this wrong and harm on us, which they're doing today through these lies and deceits with all these, you know, orders that are coming down. I do not wish to say the words on here because there are algorithms within YouTube that watch for these words and they ended up deleting videos. For example, prime example, I had a video up the other day, wasn't up for more than 20 minutes. Had 21 views, Google pulled it down. Why? Well, it was a doctor that was coming truth in the United States and she nailed it. I also want to state to everybody that all of my videos, they are on my website, warriorcalls.com, but they're also on BitChute. Okay, bitchute.com. So please go to bitchute.com if you and subscribe to me there as well, so that if they take something down on YouTube, that you will definitely and for surely be able to see it on BitChute. And I'm also going to eventually move on to Brighteon as well. So this is the state that we're at right now, and that's why time is of the essence right now with everyone in this world. Everybody must start to come together. You must start to act and spread these links, spread this truth everywhere you go. Do it honorably, do it courageously, because we have to come together right now in this world, and we are going to be a global voice come October, okay? We are going to appear on the world stage like never before as a single collective, and we're going to be carrying this light and this truth into our public courthouses. and we're going to hold court. You see, the public courthouse has that name for a specific reason. It's for we the people. And this is how simple, again, when you understand what is going on, how you're able to address these people that work or act. Remember, when you're acting, you're in a different capacity. You've lowered your standing. You're no longer the creators in this world. Remember, here's a simple trick, not a trick, but a simple truth. When you go into these court systems today, if you're being charged with provided you have caused no wrong or harm to another man or woman, or if they're trying to hit you with some fine in traffic court or some statute criminal charge for drugs or something else or whatever, all of that stuff is your property. And providing you've caused no wrong or harm to any man or woman, they have no right to be pulling you in there. And how you address it when you walk in, obviously, through before you get in the court, you put things in writing to the other side so that they know the capacity, first and foremost, at which you're appearing in that court. You're appearing, as the creator, not the created. See, now you understand what I said by the second word created. You understand that documentation, which these legal court proceedings are relying upon so that they can cloak you in that personage, okay, when you walk in. And then they place all these other terms on you. Oh, the defendant. Oh, the offender. The resident. The taxpayer. The citizen. Right? And you're not in that capacity at all when you walk into a public courthouse. You never leave that square. I'm standing here in the capacity as a man. I am one of the creators because we the people supposedly created government. And government's sole purpose in this world is to protect the property of man. That's why they were created. Remember that. They are our employees. We are the employers, yet we're seeing all of this wrong and harm being pushed and foisted upon us and our businesses. And everybody is being further threatened when they hang out these big fines if you go against what their orders are. Okay? It's all a psyops what's going on here. And all of this stuff that is occurring outside of our world today stops in a heartbeat in a minute. They are brought into a public courthouse and these concrete facts, foundational truths are laid bare. Because then you realize that Justin Trudeau or Doug Ford or any man or woman that's acting as the leader of your country, he nor any agent or officer under their control has any jurisdiction control over you because you are the creator of all of their services, supposedly. Okay? And it's very powerful. And when the judges see this, when you walk into the room and they actually see a man or woman appearing before them, and they have not been able to move them off their square to get jurisdiction control over them and then move that court case along, it gets very uncomfortable in that courtroom for them. So this is the truth that has to come forward, and it's not a comfortable truth. You know, truth sometimes is very easy to see. But the hard part in our world today is that people are accepting it and understanding it. And that's why this truth is so simple. It's laid out very simple in four foundational videos that are on my website. On the website that's there, again, it doesn't matter if you're in Canada or if you're in other parts of the world. This foundational trespass occurs against all of us. The beauty of Canada here, and it's not an I love me for Canada, but we had, the world needs to know, a Bank of Canada. It was our bank. It was a public bank for we the people. It provided money in the billions of dollars, interest-free to municipalities, to these service corporations at the provincial level, and also at the federal level. We had a debt that stayed the same from 1934 to 1974. It was $18 billion. Never changed. And they say, well, why did that happen, Chris? Well, because every dollar that was corrected again, even though it was unlawful, through taxation, had to be spent back into perpetuity into the system. We built our highways. We built our hospitals. We built our schools. We built our roads. We built so much infrastructure, and we didn't raise our collective debt, so to speak. Why? Because we the people had control of our public bank. In 1913, the United States, this is when that curtain got pulled back for me and I got that punch to the gut. I had no idea about financing, nothing. I didn't understand the creation of money. These are all the things that need to be taught to our children in schools today and not all this other crap that's going on with different people's rights and don't get me involved in the sexual side of things that they're bringing into the children in the schools. It's absolutely horrific. Not to mention that this whole lie that's going on now with children wearing masks, walking around, compromising their immune system, with the elderly people wearing masks, where everyone's living in a place, in a state of fear and terror. When you see people riding down the street or in their own bloody car by themselves and they've got a mask on, this is showing you how corrupted the consciousness of mankind is right now. And we have got a fight like we've never had before on us to bring this truth into the light and to help people come back okay, to who they are, to come back to being the man or the woman, to understand what was done to them and understand the solution moving forward. And that's why our public courthouse, I swing around a lot on things, but it's called a public courthouse because we have a right. When our creation, government, can no longer, or there's massive corruption and fraud that's going on with it, as in the case in all our countries today, because they're all controlled by the central bankers, we, as the people, have a duty to each other to gather peacefully, en masse, and bring these truths into a public courthouse, claims, okay, and move that claim in court to correct the trespass. See how simple that was to understand? It's not an I love me thing, but everybody just go back and listen to what I said there. Rewind it and listen to it again in the 30 seconds. That's all you simply need to understand, is that we have a right together as people to go. That's why we have public courthouses. So we're not out in the street fighting with each other. And this is the position, the horrific position that these people that have gone into law enforcement have been placed in. Don't forget, they've been lied first and foremost to themselves, to all, as all of us has when we're born. But then they are further compromised when they go into these roles, acting as a law enforcement agent or a peace officer. There's a duality there. There's a difference between a law enforcement agent, a police officer, and a peace officer. Okay? They've messed with these good people's hearts and minds for so long, and once they get into the system that's been set up for a long time, it's easily and acceptable to condition them because they believe within all their heart that what they're doing is right, that what they're doing is the law, and it's not, okay? This is the deceit. This is the evil that's been placed upon us, and that is why now I need all of you to share this truth with these people that are in law enforcement from the bottom right up to the top. Get this information to them any way you can and let them know that this is what's occurring and that there has never been a time more important right now in the history of this world to every single man and woman that's acting as a police officer or frontline responder in any capacity that your duty is to protect and serve the people. We need you now. We need you to come to the table. We require you that when we go to this public courthouse and we gather en masse, I'm not talking about 20 or 50 people. I'm talking about hundreds of thousands of people around these courthouses that are all awake, that are all knowledgeable, that understand exactly what's going on. Because in that moment, the people that are within that public courthouse that have been providing duties and services for the bar, and they have a legal system that's all in place, but nothing there for the man or the woman, we are going to do something that's never happened in our country, and as far as I'm concerned, in all the countries around the world, ever, in a very long time. We are actually going to hold court by and for the people. We are going to establish the jurisdiction in that courthouse. And if anybody goes against us, we've got 100,000 people outside that are going to have a little bit of problem with that. It's not coming from a place of looking to cause conflict, because I plan to walk into my public courthouse with at least 30 incredible officers, frontline responders, and they're going to bear witness as we stream this live to the world when it goes down. But we're in the stage right now that the simple communication of a trespass that has occurred when we were born must be brought forth and out into the light. And this is what I need all of you to do as best as you can, as quickly as you can. Because without this truth being present first and foremost, we are not going to be able to provide the solution 4 or 5 months down the road from now. I could go to the courthouse today if I just had 100,000 people. Because you need to know that my background, I've already filed and moved 4 different common law claims, established them in this country, and they've all been removed from people that belong to a bar. People who I don't know that trespassed on my case, my property. And they removed my property from a public courthouse, and then they wrote that we're not allowed to access that public courthouse ever again because of the paperwork that we filed. That paperwork is my claim. That paperwork is my property. And again, you put the question to them, who is the man or woman that's working in this public courthouse that has the right? Remember, they don't have rights. They have duties and obligations when they're acting in their role. So you put to them, who is the man or woman that has the right to deny me access to this courthouse? And they're going to say, nobody. That's right. There's my property. I required it filed. I required a jury to be sat, and I'm going to move a court of record moving under the common law. Okay? And that's how it works. And the legal system, the bar, is terrified. They're terrified now that people are waking up to this. And for those of you that are lawyers that are looking at this, I have a very simple message for you. The gig is up, and you need to do the honorable thing. I tell everybody that I come in contact with, because don't get me wrong, I loathe the bar, just like I loathe every single law enforcement agency that's out there today. Not the people, the corporation that was created. Remember, every corporation in this world, it operates in the world of the dead. It has nothing to do with we the people. So these men and women that have honorably gone on the front lines and they're putting their lives on the line every single day, they've got to get this truth. Have I been trespassed against them over the years? Oh, you betcha. They laugh at you. They snicker at you. But over the last couple of years, it started to change. When I go into these public courthouses, some of these honorable people, they come up to me and they say, you know, we've been starting to look at this stuff. Something's very wrong. But they're scared. And I understand that. They've got mortgages. They've got families. They've got children. They've got to put a roof over, keep a roof over their head, and they've got to keep food. But guess what? This tsunami that's barreling down on us now, this financial tsunami that's been caused because of the last 8 months of massive lies that's been perpetuated right across this world, and you have to stop and think. Look how quickly and how efficiently that this was put out into this world, and how quickly all the theatricals were put in place. For example, all the big box stores, all the beer stores, anything that's government related, they all have the mask. They all have the outfit to go along with the lie that's being perpetuated against all of us. See, and what that only does is that reinforces the fear, okay, into our fellow man. They're trying to separate all of us from each other. They don't want us to hug each other. They don't want love to be in our hearts. They don't want us to know the truth of what is actually going on. So they have to implement this continued and ever-increasing theater. Okay? And when they don't have the body count to show up, you know, what has supposedly, you know, been some pandemic that's occurred, then they have to resort to further means to compromise everybody and keeping them in a state of fear. And unfortunately, there's far too many people in this world that still watch the mainstream media. You know, that's a big problem that we have right now. But I do believe that through this collective that's actually coming together and forming around the world, this is going to be massive. This is going to be of epic proportions. We, the people, are finally going to have a real conversation together with everyone. And then we're collectively going to go on our respective countries and we're going to correct this unlawful trespass that occurs against us when we're born. Okay? That's committed all this constructive fraud with documentation around us. It's all going to simply be cleaned up. So how long have I been talking for? 1 hour. And I apologize. I haven't been looking in the chat because I got a small screen here. Let me see. Try Rocco Galante. He's a human rights lawyer. Okay, well, let's talk about Rocco Galante. Rocco Galante belongs to a society that I do not belong to, okay? Rocco Galante and every bar member, when they bring you into a court, they don't represent you. They re-present you. Look at the word. See, the bar is all about, it's a word game. They're masters of trickery, right? They've got synonyms. They've got multiple names that apply to one word, okay? And this is what you have to understand, whereas in common law, the words that you use are exact, okay? They have to be expressed exactly to how they mean. And that's why when you use a word like property and trespass, they can't get around that, okay? When you're saying who is the man or woman that's coming forward in this court that's claiming that I've done wrong or harm? Sorry, I got a little bit off there, but Rocco Galante, I'll get back to. Rocco Galante I've talked to over the years. I believe he's a great man. He's trying to do everything within his heart. Again, he's been conditioned in a world of a legal world. He believes that that's the law of the land and this is how the court structures work. That's right. That's how it works for the service corporation. It's their private courthouses. Okay? The Supreme Court of Canada is like the Supreme Court of Burger King. This is what you've got to get in your head. What you don't realize is that when you see the Superior Court of Justice, you see that in all capital letters over these courthouses. That's a corporation that's registered. Okay? Every single courthouse is registered on the stock exchange in New York. People don't understand these things. They're like, what? What is going on? That's right. So when you enter that courthouse, you have to make sure that your paperwork, which we'll get to in later presentations, correctly and properly represents who's coming into that court, the man, the claim in the court in which he's moving at that public courthouse, who the parties are. It's very, very simple to do. But Rocco Galante, and that's why I use that word simple, my claim right now to take down all this corruption would be at best 3 pages, right? And really there's only a couple of sentences that are actually dealing with the claim, but there's some other things that I wish to put in my filing to address it. Now we'll flip over to the legal world. How long was Rocco Galante's? 191 pages, right? See, all we have to address is the trespass that occurs against us when we're born. That's all that has to be brought into the light in these public courthouses. And the minute that that happens, like I said, to all you bar members, I told you the gig is up. Do the right thing. Tear up your bar cards and come and join us because we need you on this side right now. They've done this to all of us. It's not going to matter whether you're white, black, red, blue, or brown. It doesn't matter if you're, well, if you're really rich, it's not going to hurt you too bad. But the majority of the middle of class, all of us, we're about to be wiped out. We're about to be totally wiped out by this financial tsunami that's coming down that people do not understand. They think everything's going to go back to, which was not normal. It was all corrupt. They think it's going to go back to that world. It's not. Okay? And that's why what we're doing, our action, is so important. Why? Because it's three punches that we're actually giving at once. First, we're addressing the trespass. Then we're bringing a truth forward surrounding all this lie that I can't go into right now that's going on in this world. But then the third part, okay? The third part is the beautiful part, when we actually come together and we go into these courts and we're going to correct the record. That is the solution, right? And that's what we must do. So, you know, I have some people say to me, you know, that's why you don't worry about whether you see your name in upper or lower case. You just have to always understand, when anytime a piece of paper is being put in front of you, who wrote that? Okay, if someone's telling you that, oh, you have to abide by this law, who? Who is this man or woman? Because obviously there's somebody out there that believes that I'm property, right? That what these people are believing their world exists on. And as soon as you start to speak to them in the correct capacity, you see your fellow man, the wheels start to turn, and then the smoke starts to come. And this is what we've witnessed in our country, Canada, here with law enforcement, all levels of it, right? I've had many interactions with them. Like I said, I worked with them, you know, in a very intimate way on some very huge cases that they came to me about back in the day. That, again, this was one of them actually wrote to me. They said, Chris, you know, you're like a magnet for this stuff. I can't believe. And I didn't realize all this stuff, why it was going on, when it was going on. I always thought that why I was here was because of this initiative I was bringing forward through the music and entertainment industry to bring this incredible light to this world. But it wasn't. And I had to come to terms with a while ago that this is why I'm here. I'm here for this moment now. It's not an I love me thing. It is a fact. I'm here to fight for my fellow man honorably and courageously and quickly and powerfully at that public courthouse. And I'm telling you that we, the people, are being denied access to it. We have the evidence of it that's going to be shown to all of you in the coming weeks here. Once you will understand it, how we're being blocked and the horrific actions that are occurring against us, that is going to be the simple light that everyone will understand that we need to act now. Because when we address this court system, the common law being restored at the same time, what is going to happen, at least in Canada? We're going to restore our Bank of Canada. For those of you who don't know who the man by the name of Paul Hellyer is, he's the past Minister of Defense. He worked under Elliot Trudeau. Elliot Trudeau is the father of the son of Justin Trudeau, who's the Prime Minister of today. And that man committed horrific treason when he gave our patents, that's for the creation of money, to the business of international settlements in 1974. And the people knew nothing about it. And once these handful of people, families, got our patents, they've been lending money. They've been creating money and lending money to the Bank of Canada at interest, which we, the people, have been paying for through taxation. It's a massive, massive case of constructive fraud. Okay? And like I said, you have to understand, these courts have been tricking everybody. I didn't finish with the representing you. Well, I guess I did. They represent you when you go into the court as that entity that was created when you were born. That's what these legal proceedings have jurisdiction over. A frickin' piece of paper. That's it. They have no jurisdiction over a man or woman. And when you walk into that courtroom and you're standing in that capacity, you point to that man that's wearing the robe and you say, I require, which means demand, your name for my records. And he will give you his name, Bob, Susie, Sally, whatever. And then from that point on, you act like the creator. You say, Bob, what's going on here? Okay? Because is this court proceeding, is this a legal proceeding? And he's going to say, absolutely. And that's when you tell him, well, I'm not bound to any legal proceeding, only a lawful proceeding. You clearly are looking, or this court is moving under the created, not the creator. And when you say the word created, you hold up that birth certificate, because that's what that court's moving under. You go look at every single legal filing that's out there. Go and look at Rocco's. Because what the system did back in the day when they were implementing it is they attached themselves to the surname, to your last name, to your family name. Right? That was the thing that they locked into their system. But they capitalized your name all along the way. But at the end of the day, you go and look at every single legal filing that's ever been put into the courts. And you're going to see right at the top, not within the body, because they change it up within the body. They'll write you upper and lower case. Or they'll just refer to you as the defendant or the accused. But you look at the very top. That always involves what court is moving, where it's moving, what's the jurisdiction of this court, and who are the parties that are involved. And you're going to see in all the filings, at least the last name, if not all of it, everything is in all capital letters. So what you have is corporations having some sort of a court proceeding, and you're being suckered in as the entity that they created on your behalf for your benefit when you got older. But they didn't bother to tell you that these lovely benefits that they wish to give you is jail or stealing from you or taxation, right? It's incredible. And, you know, and that's why, you know, no man or woman in this world should be going through this world with this incredible truth kept from them. So I would just like to say, I guess I'll look at a couple of questions here. Now, there's no really questions. I guess people are just listening, which is absolutely beautiful. But I just want to say to everybody that this light that happened when I reached out to, again, maybe what I'll do one time is we'll do a talk about just my journey getting here, because it's been absolutely incredible. And I'm only standing here through the grace of God. And more importantly, the world needs to know that if it was not for my mother and my father and my sister, I would not be here. Excuse me. I would not be here. I have had a roof kept over my head for 20 years to get to this point. And I'm ready to go. And like I said, if you knew what, I guess what this means for me is I want every child in this world to have the same life that I had, right? To have the same love that they were given. It's horrific what's going on in our world right now. And we have to stop it, okay? I wasn't planning on doing this, but it's very deep in which this truth runs within my blood. And what started out for me to protect my family, what happened to them from enormous wrong and harm, being destroyed, wound up becoming an incredible gift, a light that I had a duty to bring forward to the world. And that's what's happening in this moment. So I would just like to say that's what this is about. And I met a great man along the way. His name, I've met many great people along the way, but a few months ago, I was clicking through YouTube, and for whatever reason, this thing came up with Common Law, and there was this video that was done from a man by the name of Jesse Casanova. Never knew him before. He's over in South Africa there, the other side of the world for me. Okay, I'm in Canada. So I reached out to him. Why? Because I saw a man with incredible talent. I saw this incredible video that he put together, even though the information that he was speaking to was wrong. It was false. He was confused in the world of legal and lawful. So I reached out to him only to help me with making and creating videos that I would hope that would go viral, right? To get this message out to the world. Well, what happened is that once I started talking to Jesse, this incredible man looked and listened with all his heart. And most people, if you contact them and you tell them, look, buddy, the 17-minute video you did was absolutely really great, but unfortunately, everything practically you said in it was wrong, they would get pretty offended. Jesse wasn't like that, and I want the world to know that. That's why he's my right-hand guy right now and all this stuff. He's incredible. So we started talking, and he was writing things down like crazy, and then he got it. And immediately, he tried to drag me into a call that was going on in the United Kingdom with the groups that are out there, because they've been struggling with trying to understand their history, right? This is what everyone's looking to. You don't look to a piece of paper to control you or provide protection for you. Remember that. The Magna Carta has nothing to do with me. It was written at a time by people that were fighting at the same time that we're doing now, that they had the king or the queen at that time put their signature to pen so that they were going to stop this arbitrary, unlimited taxation, okay, and control over them. But ultimately, it's reverted back to this because these people are psychopaths that put this system into place. They wish to control the world by any means possible. So the only way they could do it is they have to do it from the moment that you're born, from that very first breath. They've got to take and strip your consciousness away from you, from who you truly are. And they've done a brilliant job. They've done a brilliant job for a very long time. And it's time that this all comes to an end. It's time that we ride out, so to speak, and face this evil face on. And the only way we're going to do this correctly and courageously is accessing that public courthouse. And that's why I'm so blessed, because when Jesse came onto this, you know, we started talking and I was just looking for the videos, and then I started to learn about what he was able to do. He had already had begun creating the website earthunited.global. God bless him. He was trying to pull other common law groups together, but when I saw the site, how it was being created, I recognized there was this division and those people as well that were he was using as his foundation for bringing this light forward, unfortunately, were incorrect in their knowledge. Right? That's why the truth that I bring forward, it's not about me. No one is able, again, the police. This has been out on, I put the challenge out back in 2015. It's been out there for 5 years, plus also when my website launched 5 months ago, 6 months ago, whatever, 5 months ago, I put that challenge out there to law enforcement. If anything that I've put forward in those three foundational short videos, knowledge videos on my website were incorrect, as well as the video from 5 years ago, then bring it on. Come forward with your written verifiable evidence with your wet signature and I'll bring you on. I'll do a live interview with you and correct me where I'm wrong. Nobody in 5 years has done that. And that tells you that we are correct in what we're doing. And I know these people are scared, but they've got to step up to the plate now because we have a much bigger thing that's barreling down on us. Okay, that's been in the works for a very long time. These are not conspiracy theories. These are facts. Okay, and these people that are controlling the system right now, they've got through the technology a way to keep the truth from coming forward. They've got a very strong control of what is trying to come out and be brought out into the light. And I am just one of millions of lights that are going to appear in the very near future in this world that are going to be bringing this simple truth forward. This is what the world needs to see because we have people in all these incredible countries that know of what I speak of. And once they get that same access like we're going to have in all our countries as we show on that day, they're going to be able to access their countries and collectively those people will be able to correct the judicial system. They'll be able to create and restore, like in our country, their central bank, or pardon me, their public bank. It is no longer part of a central bank collective. Okay? And then our countries will be issuing money interest-free to help with the restoration and all this wrong and harm and damaging that's done. In the big picture, I'd just like to leave this with you in closing. If someone trespasses against you, for example, say somebody trespassed against me and they took $1 million from me, and then they caused me and my family horrific wrong and harm. They terrorized us for 50 years, right, before we got them into court. And then finally I walk in that day to court, and there I am moving my claim against this man or woman that trespassed against me. And when I bring that forward, what's the first thing that's going to happen when that jury is then shown the truth and they bring down their verdict? The first responsibility that that jury has to do in common law is to make me whole. So that $1 million with interest, with whatever else, you know, court fees, whatever else, there's a number that gets attached to that and then I am made whole. And then the second part of that, which is the most powerful part of it, is the punitive side. That's when our fellow man and women look at what this man or woman did to you and then they hold them accountable in a financial capacity, or they incarcerate him, or if it's bad enough, he loses his life, okay? And this is what everyone needs to understand, what we need to address and what we need to focus on, because if we don't look at this at such a simple understanding, a simple truth, as I've explained to you here today, we are never going to correct these courts, okay? We are never going to find our way back home and into the light. And that's why, you know, as I say, in the big picture, if that was $1 million someone did to me, now what I've explained to everybody is that these entities, the central banks, the Queen, and the Pope, these entities created this system. Are they liable? Oh, you better believe it. They're liable in the trillions of dollars. So what's going to happen when we establish and restore our courts and our Bank of Canada? That is when law enforcement and the militaries of the world, hopefully God bless them through their families, will be waking up. And we're going to go after and we're going to get these people and we're going to bring them into these courthouses and we are going to put a light on them and we're going to hold them accountable. And many of them, I believe that my fellow man are going to see that they do deserve a rope around their neck, but that's not for me to decide. Okay, that's only when the evidence and the truth is brought out publicly in a public courthouse and powerfully. And that's where this is heading. So that's what you need to understand. You don't need to be fearful of where, how and why money is created. When you understand that what has been done to all of us, that when we correct it simply at that public courthouse, every country is going to have trillions of dollars coming back into it. Do you know what that means to all of us? Every single dollar that you've been paid into taxation, which was all committed under constructive fraud, is going to come back to you. There's enormous wrong and harm when you understand what's occurred to all of us. Right from when we're born to when we're put in the grave. I have a show that I'm going to do in the very near future with a man who has been dealing with a will, estate, and five or six different lawyers I've recently basically shut down from what they were doing. And we're going to bring this forward so that you can see what's going on, because I am going to move this claim shortly into a public courthouse, again, under common law, because enough is enough. These people are basically, because his father had died without a will, these parasites, these bar lawyers who are all honorably, again, I always approach them from the place that they were lied to as well. That's how I communicate to my fellow man. I tell them, listen, we've all been lied to here. The problem, the decision you have before you now is that you've been given the truth. That's where the line is in the sand. If you continue to trespass and cause wrong and harm against my fellow man, I'm going to make sure that through the court system, our public courthouse, that you're going to be held liable and accountable for what you're doing. Okay, so you can imagine what the damages are for all these lawyers that have walked you in to these legal proceedings. They've represented you as some dead fiction. Okay, it's horrific. But they say ignorance of the law, right? There's no excuse for the law. You know, that's, you know, it's, and let those deceived be deceived. So that could be the bar's, you know, ultimate business model. And it's been working wonderfully, but they need to know that this truth that's coming forth now, this horrific wrong and harm that's barreling down on us with this tsunami financial that's coming because of the last 4 months of everything that's been going on and the enormous lies that this world is being told across the board, that you all have to come to the table. This isn't about whether you're a policeman or a doctor or a nurse or a contractor or whatever, a lawyer, a politician, a bureaucrat. This is about all of us at the very basic level as a man or a woman. Forget your acting roles and understand that this happened and this is the solution we have to move forward simply. And we're going to get this done because I have already met incredible people from around this world. I'm so blessed, like as I said, to still be here today. You know, for what's been going on. And every single day now, I'm being rewarded and being shown that this light is getting brighter and brighter in all these countries. All these groups that were arguing before, that were divisive, you know, that all had their own personal agendas and egos or whatever, it's all being pushed out of the way, whether it's 5G vaccinations, whether it's chemtrails, whether it's the monetary system, whether it's the court system. It doesn't matter. We all know that we're sitting in a sea of corruption. And that's a play on words because the legal world only operates in the jurisdiction of the sea. Okay, so that's what's going on collectively in our world. Mankind is trying with all its heart right now to awake while it's being confronted with massive evil. And I believe that we will get this done, but it's not going to come easy. We've got some hard lumps coming down the road here. And it's as I said, it's no one knows what the future is going to bring. We have to put our best foot forward, but this isn't something that we can actually wait till October to do. We have to get as many people, millions of people in every single country awake and acting. For those of you that aren't aware, look what happened in Germany a couple of days ago. A million people came in the streets, and they did it through the old-fashioned way, through word of mouth to each other, through using these collective social programs to bring everybody together under one thing. And they were just going after the government for these masks, I believe. Okay? So what do you think we're all going to do and how successful we're going to be when we're actually addressing a foundational wrong, a trespass that occurred against all of us at birth? And it's the service corporations, these governments that are acting in our countries that are carrying this out. And it's time we correct this wrong and harm. It's time we restore our world to a place of peace and love, which it has never been in for centuries, as far as I'm concerned. And that's why this moment is so precious moving forward. We have to come together. We have to do it now. And most importantly, we have to do it with love. So in closing, I guess I would just like to say to everybody that, my background is in the music and entertainment industry. The opening song that you heard there, that was a rough demo from 30 years. Oh boy, I'm dating myself. 30 years ago was the intro music that you heard there. That was just a rough thing in my studio. And there's going to be some more stuff coming. I've actually got a battle cry song for Earth United that is just incredible. It's called One World, One Love. And we're working on the video for that as well. It's all going to get released near the end of this month. Because, as I said, music is my passion. Music is the most incredible way of communication. So I guess I will say to everybody in closing that this final song actually couldn't sum everything up more perfectly of what we're talking about here. And I would just like to say, I'd like to thank you for letting me be myself again. God bless, and we will pick this up again next Thursday, and I look forward to you and millions more around the world hearing of this link and coming and joining us for this incredible awakening that's going on. God bless. Thank you.
Thank you.